Greetings and salutations, ladies and gentlemen. Yep, I know I said this would be Morrowind, would be the next major series on here, and I really wanted it to be, but my Morrowind is having an issue of missing textures. Regardless of multiple reinstalls and any kind of mod that says it fixes bugs or is an official or unofficial patch, or even OpenMW. I'm having random missing textures, and it's different every install. I'm not sure what's going on there. So we're going to let Morrowind take a break. Morrowind may just have to stay in my memory as being an amazing game, and I may just not have a system that can run it anymore. Apologies if... I'm going to say this up front. Apologies if you can hear the fan in the background. It is boiling where I live during the day and the time when I can record. At night, it's still fairly warm and requires a fan, especially when my computer's running. So, let's go and get started. I hope you've had a very good couple weekends. My weekends have been, I've had weekends. So, let's settle for second place here and just get this game going. I'm not going to hit continue, we're going to do a new game. I played this game long, long time ago, like right when it first came out, and I haven't touched it since. I'm pretty sure I've gotten the DLC for it, like picked it up here and there with intent to play it and never played it. And now we're gonna go ahead and get started on this. Tell you right now, my character is gonna be just a basic bare bones fighter. I just want something simple, something quick, easy, fun, something that you can watch along with a beer or two, and you don't have to worry about any craziness. Now, we're going to have a lot of people with us. They're going to be able to do amazing things. I plan on getting a wizard or two, hopefully. And that should make things a lot more fun, especially with Fireball. But this game is based on the Pathfinder RPG mechanic. Pathfinder 1, not Pathfinder 2. Pathfinder 2's is basically D&D 4E. It's just a giant MMO. Let's see here. Critical hits. We want critical hits to be normal. Death's door. What is this? I'll be right back. We're going to go through this and then we'll get started on the character creation. Okay, just to show you what we've got going on for difficulty setting. We have critical hits, death's door. You can see all of this off to the side. If you want to play along with me at roughly the same thing, there you go. That's the difficulty I've got going on. Nothing drastic, nothing hardcore. Like I said, I'm coming back into this after, like, I had to proverbially blow the digital dust off of this in a hard drive. So, let's see here. We're going to create our own character, for sure. Let's go with portraits. What's this? No. Like I said, I'm going to play something fairly boring. Just a human fighter. Ooh. People say that combination is boring, both in D&D and Pathfinder. They've said it for a long time, but... I mean... The human fighter is what makes fantasy games work. If you don't have a human fighter, then... I don't think you ever would have had D&D. The human fighter is the basic concept for D&D. Oh, man. Let's see here. Oh, that's cool. I like that. If we ever play this again, or maybe we can multi-class, maybe we'll change our portrait to that. I think you can do that in the game files. Change our portrait to that and get a become like a spell sword. That's really cool looking. I think we're going to go with this guy, though, for now. Alright. We are right-handed. That'll work for me. Body type. So, normal body type. Chonker. Or scrawny. Now let's go normal. Can we get to zoom in on that? No? Okay. Kind of like that one. We'll go with that one. Ooh, that is a Dead Man Walking skin tone right there. That's not a human skin tone at all. Alright. I guess I'll go with the default. That'll be fine. Sure, why not? Ponytail and all. What do we got for hair color? Let's go with that. Eh, it's a little too blonde for what I'm looking for. Here we go, that'll work. Yeah! I like that. I like that a lot. Little peasant boy with your metal shin guards. Okay. Yep, we're definitely going to play human. Okay, let's keep going. Grab the fighter. Now we have some different subclasses within fighter. We have the Aldori Defender. The Aldori Sword Lords of Brevoy are among the deadliest and most feared fighters of the Inner Sea. They have spent long years mastering the Aldori Dueling Sword, pitting themselves against other dueling swords and all manner of weaponry besides. Their speed and reflexes weave a net of impenetrable steel around them, from which they strike and harry their unfortunate opponents. The most common of the Aldori dueling... the most common form of Aldori... I can read, I swear, just... It's been a day. Common form of Aldori dueling... Blah, 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 and arguably the Okay. Start that sentence over from the top, Zach, please. There we go. The most common form of Aldori dueling, and arguably the easiest of the techniques to master, focuses on avoiding damage and disarming foes. These sword lords prefer to wear light or no armor. No, I'm good. I want to be armor. I don't want to be a shield. Yeah, we'll go two-handed fighter. Yeah. Some fighters focus their efforts on finding the biggest, heaviest, and most imposing weapon they can find, and training to manage and harness the weight of their massive weapons for maximum impact. These fighting school benefits only apply when using two-handed weapons. Or do we just want to go bare bones fighter? What's wrong with just a basic fighter? Yeah, we're just gonna go basic fighter, isn't it? Yeah, come on. You can still have a lot of fun with just a basic fighter. That's what I hope to prove with this. Alright, so where do we want to put our plus two? That's the question. We have a racial plus two to apply. I'm going to choose here. So do we put it strength, dexterity, constitution, wisdom, charisma? Tell you what. Let's go ahead and spend some of these points out first. Alright, so we definitely want strength to be fairly high. I would even argue a 17. And then constitution, I would want a 15. And then I do want some intelligence. Tell you what, we'll do these at 11, so that way at 12, if we just want to dump an attribute bonus, we can just dump it there. That's a good question. Do we make our strength a 19, and then a strength of? Very good question. Yeah, we make our strength a 19. Let's go glass cannon on this. Okay, we have 3 skill points. Okay. We'll throw one into persuasion. One into athletics. And... perception? Yeah, there we go. One into perception. That'll work. Okay. Choose one type of weapon. You focus. You can also choose unarmed strike as your weapon. You gain a plus one attack. With that, yes. And we will choose long sword. Like I said, we're going very basic, bare bones with this, because I don't expect this to last that long. I will get my Morrowind fixed. I don't know how I'm going to do it, but my Morrowind will be fixed because I'd much rather play Morrowind. Let's see here. We'll go combat reflexes. And then this one, this bonus one, we will choose... what do we get? Select one type of armor AC by that armor increases by one, so base... Ooh, that's cool. We'll grab heavy armor then. No, let's go blind fight. That'll work. Blind fight, easy peasy. All right, what is your name, good sir? Your name will be Devrin Darkmoon. There we go. You'll be a chaotic good individual.
I have no use for this.
All I see is blackness.
I have no need for this.
You're done for.
There we go. We'll go brave. That'll work. We'll choose... There we go. The 10th of Kuthana. Why not? Or... The 4th of Callistral. Well, there you go. That'll work. 4th of Callistral.
Adventures await.
Alright. Sound a little bit drunk there, but that's okay. Okay, everything looks good to me. Let's take a look at the character sheet one last time. Or we can't change anything. Hand it over to the DM. Make sure the DM thinks everything looks good. Alright, let's get started. Not just the phylactery, you have to kill all the phylacteries. And then you kill the lich the final time to truly defeat the lich. Otherwise the lich will just go to the nearest phylactery, pop out, or inhabit something, and then pop out of that, and then keep making more phylacteries. And you basically have to start over from square one. Generations down the road, because the lich
Our
will just have nothing but time.
Oh. At the mansion of an Aldori sword lord. Drawn by the promise of a most dangerous task and a commensurately huge reward, heroes of all stripes gathered here.
Okay. I forgot about the narration.
Where are they? This is taking forever! It didn't even say what this was for, just that the Aldori were looking for heroes. Who are the Aldori anyway, rich folk?
If you can't be patient, no one's keeping you here. Just go back to your mountains or whatever hole you crawled out of. The Aldori sword lords run.
Did he say hole or whore?
They're also the richest.
I'm going to assume he said hole. It sounded like he said whatever whore you crawl out of, though.
All right, you purple toad, just shut your trap. And if you can't, I'll help you.
Hush! Quiet! They're coming.
Who is? Why can I be a part of this? Ooh, they just materialize out of the shadow. So cool.
Greetings, everyone. I am Sword Lord Jamandi Aldori, and this is Lord Mayor Yosef Salimius of Rustov. Welcome to my mansion.
You know, Sword Lord's one of those titles that it reads better
we
than it sounds.
Thank you from the bottom of our hearts for responding to our call. You may be few, but that's unavoidable. We need only the best of the best for this task. And I see true heroes before me, strong and fearless, exactly what Rustov needs.
Okay.
Thank you, Lord Mayor. Now, to the point. South of here, just beyond Brevoy's border, lies a region known as the Stolen Lands. This is disputed territory, and while it's long been claimed by nearby states, it's never been truly taken. I won't bore you with the legal technicalities. Suffice to say that anyone with enough courage and power to seize the stolen lands and name themselves Baron or Baroness, claiming dominion, well, none of the neighboring states would be able to challenge it.
Why not King?
Of course, Rustoff would be first.
I got a question. Why not King, huh? Also, if it's never been truly taken, why call it the stolen lands? Of its founder. This whole thing smells fishy. I don't like this.
Unfortunately, one serious obstacle stands between you and this title. A gang of bandits holds sway in the Stolen Lands. Their chief, who they call the Stag Lord, considers himself the rightful owner of these lands, and no one has yet been able to challenge his power. Bring me his head, and you'll be able to return to the Stolen Lands as their legal ruler. Any questions?
No one else has a question. Okay, I've got a few questions. Why not just make the Stag Lord the Baron?
That's a good point. As I see it, this Stag Lord already holds power over the region with confidence. Many noble bloodlines were started by bandits who just got lucky, weren't they?
Perhaps because we do have standards to maintain. This room has seen many celebrations.
Ooh, I feel like that was a dig at
Jamondi Aldori's
lineage there.
Bandit lord?
Leave it to the dagger ear,
but that's
huh?
That's one thing that's never happened here, and it won't while I still breathe.
All right, knife ear. I think she just put you back in your place. Another question. Hi, Devrin again. You're helping us found a barony. What do you gain from this? And again, why just a barony? I assume we'll be under your control then, right? We're just going to be a puppet for you?
Don't ask stupid questions. Why should you even care? What they have to gain and why, that's for Lady Aldori and I to discuss. It's none of your concern. Your only concern is to swing your sword around or whatever it is you do.
Okay.
Of course, we stand to benefit from this enterprise. But if you're concerned that we intend to rule your country from afar, using you as a front, well, please know that these concerns are unfounded. Let's just say that we have a strong interest in the region's stability. We have need of a ruling power we can negotiate with, not bandit gangs and monster hordes.
Oh, thanks for founding those concerns now by what you just said. You literally just confirmed and denied in the same breath that you want a puppet. What is going on here?
Is it the smell of unspoken words and political intrigue?
Amen. Thank you, Kaisi. Or Casey, or whatever your name is. I'm going to assume Casey, probably. Alright.
I will, of course. I'm the leader of this team, after all.
Who invited the child to the table? Get this purple-haired child out of here, please.
We haven't yet begun, and you already speak of divvying rewards. What makes you think we'll even succeed? There's little point arguing over who gains the title when we'll most likely lose our lives there.
All right, very good point, Dwarf. Very good point.
If I may please answer the question.
Well, we're waiting.
We believe you're all equally deserving of a noble title. Over the course of your expedition, it will be up to you as a team to decide which of you is best suited to rule.
Oh, so you're just delegating that responsibility to whoever survives. Okay. All right. This all makes perfect
Excellent.
Sense.
Excellent. Oh, boy. Tomorrow. For now, you can take some time to get to know one another better. Or you can head straight to your guest rooms to get some rest. You'll find we've already prepared supplies for you there. And thank you again for agreeing to take part in this expedition. I wish...
Thank you again, with all my heart, for replying to this call. The flare in your eyes reveals your courage, the unshakable will that distinguishes true heroes. I look at you, O champions of Rustoff, and doubt not for a second that you'll be victorious. So venture forth toward your feet. Go, and return in triumph.
Really? Can someone get me a glass of wine, please? Oh, hi, child. Oh.
This is my first real adventure.
Gnome or halfling? I'm sorry, I have a hard time telling. Sure. The name's Devrin.
Likewise. Actually, I also wanted to ask you something.
Okay.
How do you feel about this Tartuccio fellow? I think he's pretty obnoxious, personally. He appointed himself head of the team, and he's just after the Baron's crown, or whatever it is Barons wear. Doesn't matter. I don't like him. I think you should be team leader. When I first saw you, I couldn't help but think, now here's a real hero.
That shouldn't be an exclamation point for how she said songs. It.
This is the person I'll write my book about.
Wow. Damn, cool.
I should have led with that. Please, just let me explain. You know what the trouble with most heroes' biographies is? They're always written years later, based on the tales of, best case, people who saw things from the outside. Worst case, someone heard about it from their brother, who heard it from their friend, who heard it from their cousin, and so on, adding a new batch of lies each time. Every time I read about a heroic journey, I think to myself, why didn't they just bring a bard with them to write it all down properly?
Very good point, Lindsay. Very good point.
And then I thought, I could be that bard. I just needed to find a suitable hero and volunteer to follow along on their glorious adventure. A great plan, huh? And here we are, with a heroic journey lying before us. Who's going to be the hero? Some dwarf who keeps muttering about how we'll all die? Or maybe that horrific scythe lady? Or, gods forbid, Tartuccio? No way.
What about the barbarian?
Oh yeah, she's fantastic. You can tell she could tear a bear's head off with her bare hands, but she kind of scares me just a little. But, I mean, her sword's twice as big as I am. She could cut me down without even noticing. Just think on it a bit, all right? I'm sure you'll agree.
Oh, what, for me to be the subject? Why not you, Lindsay? Why not? What happens if you become Baroness? Hmm?
All right. I'm going to my room to write.
It'll become an autobiography, then. Morning. Might as well base it off yourself, child. I mean, small person? Okay. No actual dialogue. Anybody else got any actual dialogue? What is that thing on that man's back? Okay. Does she have anything else to say if we go talk to her privately? Nope. Cool. Let's get out of here. Oh, hey. Alright. No one else really had anything else to say. Let's go take a nap. What's going on?
The mansion's under attack. We need to help.
I literally just got into my room.
The villains broke in and started.
You realize how big
everyone.
This place is?
I barely made it. Hurry.
Wait.
We have to help the guards fight off the Bandits attackers or we'll all be cut down one by one.
Yeah, sure. Let's do it. Ooh, someone's having a good time out there.
You're not going anywhere.
Oh, is that so? Oh, they gave me a shield? Okay.
Alright. We can do it.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Give me everything you own. Give me everything you own. Chain shirt. Is that better than what I have on? Is it tab? C? Yeah, it's C. No. I. Yeah, there you go. I. What am I wearing? Scale mail. Better than just a chain shirt. Not by much, though. Not by much at all. Wow. Okay. Alright, cool. Let's go. Oh, hey, Lindsay. Oh, there's Tartuccio down there. I recognize the purple-haired freak.
What shall I do with this one?
We'll finish him later. He won't get away.
Alright.
Strike with all your might!
Let's go get this guy. Just casually walk up to him. Sup? Missed. Ooh, there's that combat reflexes coming in.
You're just in time. A bit longer and I'd have been... I don't even want to think about
it. You've been Eiffel Towered, my friend.
What a terrible loss this would have been. But it's all right now. I'm safe, sound, and unscathed. Ready to lead you to victory.
Okay, all right. Hush up, buddy.
Lady Jamandi's holding the line in the banquet hall. You know, the one where she had us gathered before. We need to make our way.
I'm well aware where the banquet hall is.
And along the way, we'll try to save some of these dummies who are supposed to accompany us to the stolen land.
I have a longbow too? Oh, okay.
Speaking of dummies, take this ring. Quiet now, so that little fool doesn't hear us. She might try to steal it herself. It's magical. It'll protect you. You'll need it while you work to defend me.
I feel like you're trying to make... I don't trust you, Tartuccio. No, I don't trust you at all, buddy. So I tell you what we're going to do. We're going to take a look at all this. Can we... Get this out of here. Can we throw stuff onto these guys? No, but we can take those daggers and sell them later. I am not going to wear this ring. Drop that bad boy. Nope. Alright, cool. You darn right I did that right in front of you. Come on, let's get out of here. Right, gotta go this way. Oh, got more bad guys. We've got three of them this time. Okay. They have a higher initiative than we do. Alright. Alright, Lindsay, you get right there and...
Serves you right.
Oh, Lindsay. Come on, Tartuccio. There we go. Get up to here. Get up to here. There we go. Now it's my turn. Yes. Yes, it is. I'm going to close the distance. Get into melee with all three of them. There we go. And tank it up, baby. Miss. Haha. Get wrecked. Ooh, the combat reflexes again. I'm telling you, those things are... I love those things. Alright. Can you shoot him now? Nope. You are shooting into melee, so I guess that's a bit of a problem. There we go. And Tartuccio. With your... You're wielding a crossbow as well, right? But you don't have any of the crossbow stuff. Interesting. You do have Ray of Frost, though. That should be able to hit both of them with it, yeah? Just the one? Okay, cool. Thought it hit anything in the line, but that's just me. Maybe that's a D&D thing. We'll hit the one that's already injured. Ooh, we will not. We will miss. Okay. Man, I gotta love the combat reflexes.
Any last wishes?
Yeah! Give this thing a good old burning hands. Eat it! Ooh, toasty. I can dig it. Hit him. Or miss him. Cool. Gotta love those random dice rolls. There we go. Combat reflexes kicks in again. Fantastic. Alright, let's loot. Yes, let's take all of those. Those are health potions, yes? Yes, they are. Sweet. Alright. Alright, everybody. Let's go. How do I take one of those health potions? Let's take just one of these. Use. There we go. That'll work.
No stopping now.
Let's get through here.
It's the end for you rats!
Alright, Lindsay. Get up there and get ready to witness the glory that is the barbarian.
This is where I step in.
See? Oh, man. So good. Two-handed weapon, too. Alright. There we go. You know what? Let's just go ahead and close the gap as much as we can. We should have done that with the full round movement. But it's so good. Alright, Tertuccio, get over here. And... acid splash. Ooh. Oh, I like the cool... I like the spell effect of the acid splash. That looks awesome. Get over here.
Hit that. Serves you right.
Good hit. Two down. Can I at least hit this one to not look so... Ooh, good night! Turn that one into goop. I like it.
Oh, it's you. Stay up from under my feet or I'll strike you down. Blood for Gorum!
Blood for the blood god. That's a barbarian through and through. What's wrong with barbarians?
That's exactly how heroes should be.
Thank you, Lindsay. I told you should use her as the focus of your book.
Stupid, sweaty, and always looking for something to gobble up or lop the head off of? Callistria, save me from such heroes.
Okay, buddy. What do we got in here? Are we just gonna watch this? I mean, we're right in the doorway. Can't we get involved? This is your last chance. Drop your weapons and we'll spare your lives.
So generous. I'm afraid I can't offer you the same courtesy.
Holy crap, a Frostjar just walked through, killed one of his own. Oh, I forgot about the Frostjar in the beginning. I don't remember fighting that at all. Oh, that ain't good, yo. Alright, I do remember the cave-in. Ooh, boy. Alright, let's go check the bad guy. What did the bad guy have on them? Club. Oh, had a health potion. We'll take that. Can we just leave? Can we just go out the door? Nope. Okay. Cool. I was willing to say to hell with the barony there for a second. What do we have? A spear. Nice. Long sword. I think that's what I've already got. And that shield is about what I've already got. What kind of potion is this? Enlarge. Ooh, nice. Okay. Let's go. Come on. How do we... securely locked. How do we get through here? Oh, that's... I forgot that's how they do the skill checks in this game. No, that's right. Come closer.
You deserved it.
Good hit. Walk over here.
Strike with all your might.
Good kill. Go get a little bit closer. Eh. Not a very good hit on his part. And yeah, why not? We'll do Ray of Frost again.
Leave this one to me.
Okay, you didn't do much.
Any last wishes?
Ooh. Bloody goop. Alright. Let's loot. Let's go forward. Alright, what do we have here? Armory, I'm sure Jumanji went... no, we're not breaking into the armory. How do we get out of here? Let's go this way. Can't be opened without a key. Oh, I mean to shut that door. Is there another door over here? No. Do I have to go to the armory, really? Okay. I don't want to do it because Tertuccio suggested it. I don't like Tertuccio.
Applause, please.
He's like obviously the bad guy. Let's see here.
What have we here? This chest is full of gold. I guess it's for the guard's salaries, all things considered. Well, those freeloaders don't seem to have been working too hard for it. Maybe we should pocket it instead.
What? No, we're heroes, not thieves.
Who said we were stealing it? We'll just take the gold for safety so the assassins don't get it. And then we can heroically return it to Jamandi when this is all over.
No, Totuccio. We're in the middle of a battle. We're trying.
Finally, a voice of reason.
Do what you want. I don't care. It was just a suggestion. But there's a lot of money in that chest, and with all these bandits running around, it wouldn't be any better if they stole it.
But they won't, because we're going to be victorious. What we want... Is it in here? Yeah, it's in here. Take that key. That's got to be the key for this. There we go.
Oh, familiar faces. I hope you're not so frightened as to swing at every shadow. It's me, Jaethal. I don't recommend advancing down the hallway, assuming you value your life, of course. There were a few people with me, and you can see what happened to them.
And just how did they all end up dead while you don't seem to have a scratch?
I'll answer but briefly and just once. Further scares and explanations will wait until we aren't being hunted by a group of assassins. Deal? All right. I'm undead. These traps are deadly to the living, but they're harmless to me.
Hence the two corpses at your feet, okay.
What do you mean undead? Really? Like zombies or skeletons or...
Vampire?
As I said, further explanations will wait until later.
Vampire.
All you need to know right now is that we're on the same side, and we have to fight off a small army of hired assassins. Let's get to it.
I agree. Welcome to the group.
March on.
All right.
I see something.
All right, so do I.
I'll make my own legend.
Anything is possible.
I need you to disarm that.
Applause,
good
please.
Job. Alright.
Would you look at that?
I see it.
I wrote it.
Alright, Lindsay. The bard, aka the musical rogue.
I see something. Adventures call to that.
Okay.
It's just not my lucky day.
Do it again.
Applause, please.
So another one? Oh, no, there's not. Okay. Oh, we didn't loot these two down here. Are these two lootable? No, they're not lootable. Okay. Alright, let's get out of here. I think we gotta go this way through here, or through these doors. Probably through these doors. Come on, guys. Where are we going? Alright, there we go. Is it in here? Oh, there's some bad guys. What are you dallying for? I'm telling you, Jamandi's cash has to be here somewhere. Oh, it's up! Before... Stop! I hear someone coming. Hey, I got top initiative that round. Awesome. Let's close the gap. Alright, Lindsay, you go here. And shoot that one. Miss wildly. Alright, vampire lady. You also close the gap. Good job. Haha. Ooh, went around the vampire lady, huh? I don't know if that's a good choice. Oh, why did I move you into melee? Oh well. It'll work out in a second. Good hit. What does this do again? No, I'm not gonna fight defensively against these guys.
Serves you right.
Good hit.
Unworthy.
Ooh. A miss, huh? They've got her flanked. Giggity. Yep. Magic missile. Good job. gooified that one.
Strike with all your might.
Ooh, gooified that one too. Alright. Is there anyone in here? Open the door. Is there anyone in here? No, there was not. Alright, come on. Nope. I thought there may have been someone in there they were trying to get after. Let's open this door. Let's go through. Oh, hey, the courtyard. The hall should be nearby from here, I think. Ooh, Tartuccio's in the front, huh? Where do we get you? There we go. Got you there. Got an idea for you, Tartuccio. Burning hands. Ooh, good stuff. All right, Lindsay. Badly injured. Focus on the badly injured. Good kill. There we go. Starting to slowly come back to me how to do Pathfinder combat. I still have this bow in my back. Never used it. Wild miss. Alright, vampire lady. Give good old Devron a flanking bonus there, would you? Thank you. Oh hey, the tiefling.
You cannot stand against me.
Can you do magic missile again? You can. Magic missile, please. Good hit. Lindsay, fire at this one.
Last wishes.
That literally bounced off of him. Literally. Oh my gosh. Okay, Lindsay. Alright, there you go. One more down. Alright, vampire lady. Ooh. Ooh, good hit. With a tiny little mote of flame.
Wretched thing.
Ooh, man, vampire lady, you gotta hit better than that. Let's see here. Another ray of frost. Ooh, that's a bad miss, my friend. Why am I calling you a friend, you Tartuccio, you little scumbag? Like a used car salesman. Alright, let me get in here. Let's do flanking. And hit. There we go. There we go. Combat reflexes.
Everything is so much fun with a little fire.
I agree.
What a night, huh? I thought I was all alone. It's good you're here. A bit boring, chasing fool assassins without anyone watching the show.
Ooh, are you coming on to me? Because I like it.
It's not fun at all. Many people have died for nothing.
Oh my god, Lindsay, live a little in the moment, huh? You sound like a Kelishite, am I right?
Of course. I'm from Kadira. But tales of hot deserts and shady oases can wait until the fighting's finished. But if you'd like to share a dinner and pleasant conversation, just say the word. I like making new friends.
Well, that was the first step of making friends. My name's Devron Darkmoon.
I am Kaisi.
Kaisi,
okay. One of the many here who seek a better fate. Answering the call of Lady Jamandi. But unlike the others, I never dropped my guard, day or night. It's why I'm still alive.
Well, let's have that dinner conversation another time.
I don't know where you're heading, but I'll be at the entrance to the main hall. I think I saw some guards there. Join me there, if you wish.
Yeah. Take care. Oof. No, the dwarf!
Otis, I can sense your silhouette hovering over me. It won't be much longer. Soon we shall meet, O Lord of Oblivion.
I mean, if you want to die, that's fine. Here, someone hand me a health potion.
Too late. Forgive me. Oblivion is calling. That's impossible. Oh, it seems you might be right. It seems I will live. I suppose I must postpone meeting my god, not for long, I'm sure. But while we remain in this transient world, Aram is at your service.
Thank you, Aram. Guess that's a minor issue with the Delph cult, but come on with us. Always you could use a cleric. Let's see here. Where are we going? It's down through here, I think, isn't it? Oh, here. There we go.
You, run and get an axe. You, bring more water. You, stay here and hold our defense. Those assassins are still around here somewhere. Aha! Some of our guests survived. Good. You need to get to the banquet hall and help Lady Jamandi. No, we'll manage. I've got my best people here, those who still live. Your place is by Lady Aldori's side.
Okay.
It doesn't seem right. What if some of the guards are wounded? We need to help them.
Where's the hall through that wreckage?
We've almost put it out at the entrance, so your main concern should be to not inhale any smoke. Hold your breath and take the first right, then head straight down the hallway.
All right, let's go, everybody.
Fire doesn't frighten me, thanks to Hell's blood running in my veins. I'll go ahead and wait for you on the other side. Catch up!
Okay.
May Abadar keep you safe.
You as well, but we're going to use a little bit of intelligence here. Can we go wet ourselves in the fountain first? No? Okay.
Just letting the ink dry.
Yeah, I think it's going to get very dry in a second. Oh, what am I? No, I want everybody. Come here. Alright, let's do this. Oh, there we go. And so our adventure started. Earlier and much more tragic than we'd expected. The whole team who'd gathered in the hall yesterday had been reduced to but a handful of brave souls, led by Devran Darkmoon, and not at all by that scoundrel Tartuccio, no matter what he might have imagined of himself. Jamandi Aldori was waiting for us, but to get to her, we'd have to march through fire, literally. As we approached the burning building, we, drenched ourselves with buckets of water, tried to find a less dangerous passage, covered our noses and mouths before we rushed inside. We drenched ourselves with buckets of water. Prudence is the key to victory. Before moving through, we thoroughly wet our clothes and hair. After that, we covered our noses and mouth. We gotta go now. The combat's still going on. It's a good thing we hadn't wasted any time. After entering the except for drenching ourselves in water. After entering the building and taking just a few steps forward, the wall behind us slanted and crashed down with a terrible crackling sound, blocking the way back. While we may not have planned on going back, if we'd come in a little bit later, the flaming logs and red-hot bricks would have surely fallen right on our heads. Regardless, we were left with only one way to go, forward. The hot air burned our lungs, our eyes watered from the smoke, but Devran Darkmoon led us stubbornly through the flames, while Tertuccio did nothing useful at all, except for complain about the smoke and use his magic of I may not totally kind of have a crush on Tertuccio. We made it to the hallway leading to the banquet hall when we heard someone calling for us. It was Valerie, one of the guards I'd chatted with a bit in the banquet hall. Even then, in that calm setting, I'd been stunned by her beauty. Ooh, Lindsay. Damn. But now, amid the smoke and flame, she looked like a celestial avenger. I don't think celestial is the one you're looking for. Demonic, probably. Anyway, an armored deity, menacing but beautiful, merciful. Beautiful and merciful, descending from the higher spheres to help us poor mortals. Wow. She held a burned, barely living guard in her arms. There are two more, she shouted as she passed by us. They're wounded! Help me pull them out! Tartuccio grumbled something about how Jamandi was waiting for us. Meanwhile, Devran Darkmoon, we're gonna save the guards. Burning alive is a horrible way to go, even though I use burning hands on the other guy. Yep, we got the athletics check. Awesome. Saving the poor fellows didn't take long. We lifted them up and carried them away from the fire. Only then did Valerie pause to catch her breath, wipe the sweat from her face, her beautiful, luscious face. Thank you. That was truly noble of you, she said. And now, let us rush to Lady Aldori's aid. Come on, all the more the merry. If we hadn't have done that, we wouldn't have Valerie for the upcoming fight. If I remember that, it's going to take a little bit of time. Ensuring the guards we'd rescued were relatively safe, we made our way to the hall where the battle was already in full swing. And that we will pick up in the next episode. Thank you very much for joining me on this first little episode of this game. And I hope you enjoy it as much as I think we're going to. And like I said, Morrowind may forever be on the horizon for now until I get that issue fixed, but I will get it fixed. Take care, everyone.